Something I recommend y'all doing, if you have the problem like I have, where just say you do a few pressing exercises back to back as you're beginning your chest workout, and your front delts are always the reason basically you have to stop pushing because they're fatiguing before your chest. You can do something that's called a pre-exhaust, where you do an isolation exercise on the chest for a few sets and then move into pressing. Like, you're not trying to, you're trying to get blood in the muscle and like warm it up and pre-exhaust a little bit. So then you move to your pressing, your chest is already a little bit fatigued, so it'll fatigue quicker than your shoulders will. I just did it for the second one because I don't have that problem for my first three sets of bench. It's just when I move right back into some underhand grip or some push-ups, my front delts go like that. So, and me just throwing in those two sets of cable flies completely took that away when I went back to my presses. So give that a try if that's something that bothers you or aggravates you or gets in the way of your workouts. I've been doing some, I'll be finishing off with band external rotations. I'm not going to do those tonight, but I'm going to do my line dislocates. I'll do, so
I'll show you all those.
These are really good, just basically for your whole posterior chain, and really helps open up your chest and front delts, you know, strengthens your rear delts, the upper back, low back, like I said, posterior chain, glutes, hams, even get your core a little bit in there too. So it's good to help, and it's really good range of motion training. Like, it helps you with your range of motion, getting strong going through that. So I guess that's stability work too with it. And so it'll help with impingement, and if you have rounded shoulders and stuff, it'll help open you up. This is what it looks like. Just gonna do two sets.
Get you a broomstick, anything. I just use a band, anything straight. But you want to plant your toes into the ground, lock your knees out, flex your flex your hamstrings, glutes, and kind of suck your abs in a little bit, contract. And keep your chin tucked in. Come on, come out with it. It's really hard to keep everything tense, but you got to focus. Just bring it back.
I only rest 60 seconds in between these because it's just for the really range of motion to open myself up.
because I've been having some knee, a little bit of knee issues, so I haven't been training the legs the past 2 or 3 weeks. But I'm still hitting my calves, trying to bring those back up to where they used to be.
All right, everybody, just got home, back from the gym. I need a chest session, a new chest workout routine. I'm about to go ahead and get my first workout meal, and I'm going to do some stretches in the chest, shoulder, and forearm stretches. That's going to be it. And, I may post a video later of my stretch routine. There's some of the shoulder routines I do, I learned to rehab, and it's good for impingement and shoulder range of motion. So be on the lookout for that. Physique update at the end of my bulk, which will be coming, I believe the 30th is in this week. I'm not 100% sure yet. I'm not 100% sure on that. Let's see. Yeah, 30th is the end of the, so I'll probably record that the 29th and 30th. I'll be posting a full day of eating soon. I'm at 2,700 calories right now. I don't think I'm going to go up any higher than that in this last week, so. But be on the lookout for that too. And, you know, follow my journey. I'm about to start leaning. Like I said, I'm trying to get 7-8%. So if you're bulking, you know, do it along with me. Let's get shredded together. And there'll be some sick cunts out on the beach, out at the lake. You know, wash your clothes and your abs. If you get you some hamburger meat or go out to eat, you don't want to pay for that cheese. Bring in that block of cheese. Shred it right there on your ass. That's what I'm trying to do. But that's enough. All right, everybody. Peace.